Hi guys, and welcome to yet another very exciting Adobe Illustrator tutorial. And in this tutorial we will learn how to group and ungroup different objects together and what is the benefit of grouping and ungrouping. For example, you are in a situation working with an Illustrator file that certain piece or certain area of the image needs to be altered. For example, you just want this banner or this, you know, shared maker to be altered, its color, its size or something, but you cannot do it because it is grouped to something else like this. It is just grouped to the name of the shop. There is barber shop, but it can be grouped to a lot of other things, you know, like this, and the whole shop can be grouped together, and many sort of groupings can be made for your own choice. Sometimes groupings are useful, sometimes they are innocent, I mean annoyance, because you know, if I want to move or resize this or make it size larger, as you can see, many things, you know, change with it. If I want to just alter the name here, and because it is grouped with this shared, it's also going to alter its size too, which makes the whole picture or illustration ruined and look terrible. So what we can do is to first isolate that object if it is not individual layer like this thing. Okay, so to do that, first you need to select your stuff of the whole group, then go to the object menu, then click on this option which says ungroup, and the keyboard keyboard shortcut for it is shift plus control plus G. You click it, then click away, and now when we select it, as you can see, now our stuffs are ungrouped. Now for example, I just want to alter individual layers in here also, or I just want to alter now my barbershop name here, and now it looks better. I want it to make it bigger, I want to change its color and stuff. Now I can do all those sort of stuff. Now it will only effective on this stuff. Okay, actually something is happening in here. Okay, now it's looking good. Okay, now I suppose I want to select some of these smaller parts. I want some of them to be removed, just one after another, alternate ones to remain, but it's still group. Now I can even divide this small group into more smaller group by going to object again and then clicking on the group ungroup again. Now what happens is that everything in here has been divided into its own smaller group. So the lesson from this is that if you have a larger group then subgroups in it, and the first time you go to the object menu and ungroup those stuff, it's not gonna break all the groups into smaller groups. First of all, it's gonna break the larger group into the subgroups, then those subgroups which have more subgroups in it, then it can be divided into those. First of all, these two things which were in one group, they were divided. Now these things are inside this smaller group, and it, now the second time we ungroup them, they are being, you know, ungrouped. I'm going to select these things, one of them at a time, like this. Hit the delete key, and now you can see I made the illustration even worse, but still okay. Now if I want to put it back on the plans, the problem is now they are all ungrouped and they are not coming together. Now how to group those things again? The simple command for that is on the keyboard, of course, Control G, that is its shortcut. You can find the command under the object menu, just above the group ungroup command, there is the group command. When you click it, now those pieces are grouped back together. And now we can move it back to the place where it fits. So now it looks like this, and many other alterations like this can be made to it if your illustration or your works need isolated work on an individual layer. So make sure that they are isolated from the other groups, they are ungrouped, and then you can make the changes, everything that you want with it. And once that is done, your work is done, and then you can shift to your client and make a lot of money. probably on one smaller illustration job, $1 million. Of course, I'm kidding. Okay, you know, even if that was a ridiculous lie, I need to, you know, say a disclaimer in the end. Otherwise, someone might sue me that, okay, you said $1 million, and now there are nothing. So, with that said, and with my terrible jokes in the end, I take my leave from you guys for today, and hope to see you in the next tutorial. Until that time, goodbye.